Hey guys, Donald here, ARCRVA. Now, I've got a good one today. I've got a real good one. I actually told you all on the Facebook group, I got a deal. I got a steal of a deal. I mean, I should probably be arrested for the deal I got, but because I actually paid for it, I mean, the person that allowed it to happen. Enough. Let's just get in. Here we've got an HP Envy 750-177C. You can actually buy this thing either at Best Buy or Walmart. One of the two. Now, there's a couple of good things about this, a couple of bad things. One of the good things about this system is it has an i7-6700 in it. Good, right? Yeah. Decent processor, real nice. Almost productivity workstation style. Yeah, I'd say that's pretty good, don't you? Well, see, here's where it gets really great. I bought this computer for $10. I'm not lying. Somebody else paid well over $300-$400 for this. Just the tower alone cost probably that much, if not more, when it was released. But I paid $10 for it. Now, to give you an idea how I did that, there is a recycling place around where we live. I actually had gone over to take a bunch of aluminum over there to them one day. They had just gotten a bunch of stuff in. I said, hey, you all still selling the computers for 10 bucks? They said, yeah, sure. I said, all right, you know, just let me look here for a bit. I want to see if I find anything interesting. Now, that being said, I did not go there that day to buy anything. I went there to get money for recycling. Well, I came across this puppy. I saw the sticker on the front bottom here that says i7. I went, you've got to be kidding me. Somebody threw this out? Okay, this is too good to be true. The CPU can't be in there. I mean, the processor just isn't there. So, I looked at the guys and said, hey, you know, do you have a flathead screwdriver I can borrow? I need to pull this heatsink off this board to see if the CPU is there. They said, sure, here you go. Well, like, wait a minute, why do you need... I said, I need to know if the CPU is there. To know if I want it. I pulled the heatsink off. The CPU's there. I look at the side panel, look up the specs for it. I rub the thermal paste off of the CPU. I confirm it is an i7-6700. I'm sitting there going, yes, we're buying it right here, right now. Now, I've had this system for the better part of 2-3 weeks now. Now, the reason it's taken this long to pull the video together is because there are two things I had to do. One, I had to make sure that the power supply stuff in it was good. Two, I had to wait for RAM. Now, unfortunately, this system was designed with a DDR3 motherboard. This DDR3 isn't standard. It is not running at 1.4 to 1.5 volts. It's running at 1.35 volts and lower. That's because the 6th generation Intel I-series was low voltage. Yeah. Yeah. Intel should have been shot for that. But that's okay. That's okay. Because I went on Newegg, ordered a stick of Crucial RAM. I'm holding a bit of Crucial here in my hand. 2 gig stick for $17.99. Now, that RAM came from 1-800 memory, or 1-800-4 memory, or something to that extent. I get the stick in, you know, the week after I get the board, and, you know, the system, because I test all my RAM won't work with it because it's not low voltage RAM. So I get on Newegg, I order the stick in. I get the stick in. I'm immediately calling the shipper because the stick they sent me was the incorrect stick. They told me in a voicemail that, you know, they can't get that RAM anymore. Well, wait a minute. Crucial still, I went to Crucial's site and I checked. They still sell that RAM. So how can you not get the RAM anymore? I'm confused here. Okay, whatever. They were nice. They said, look, we sent you the wrong thing. What's your email address? We'll send you a return shipping label. You ship it back. Done. You know, we'll return the money. I said, okay, fine. Yep. Fine. Done. And they did. So I got on the phone with Crucial, said, hey, what have you got? What do you have that you can help me out with? You know, I've got this board, I need this particular type of RAM. I really only need a two gig stick, that's it. I'm like, well, yeah, we actually do still make the low voltage memory RAM. I'm like, all right, you know. So, you know, I'm on the phone a couple times, going back and forth. And, you know, we brought, you know, because I'm getting ready at this point. I found a 4 gig stick for $37.99, I believe. So I'm getting ready to buy this 4 gig stick. So I call him up again. I go, I got a question. I'm like, what? Can I use this RAM in a standard voltage DDR3 board? They said yes, as long as it says 1.35 volts. You can up it into 1.5 volts just fine. That RAM is dual voltage. I said, awesome. So, I didn't just buy it for $37 and some odd change. I paid for it and got 2-day shipping on it for the added $20. So, this stick of RAM alone from Crucial cost me $60. Yeah, basically cost me $60. So I figure if I'm going to spend that kind of money, I need to make sure it works with other DDR3 boards that are standard. So we got it in. System booted up, posted. Complained about a hard drive. I'm like, all right, that's easy to fix. Plugged one in. Rebooted. Did great. I'm like, awesome. We got a working system. Great. All right, let's check the PCI Express slots. So, put a video card in. Starts giving us post errors again, like no RAM. I'm like, okay. Let's pull it out. Turns back on post. I'm like, okay. Maybe something's wrong with that card and I don't know. So I put it. Few more cards in. Same thing happened. It would not boot into those VGA cards. So we're like, let's try something that isn't VGA. I put in, and here's the board that came out of it. I put in the 16X slot, a wireless LAN card that's 1X. Okay? I put the card in this slot, system would not post at all. Wouldn't even give a screen. Put it in this slot, it would work fine, and it would post, but if you put a video card in this 1X slot, it never worked. So we're kind of sitting there, I'm kind of sitting here going, it's got to be the board. It's got to be the board. So I'm like, all right, let's look, see what a new board costs. Okay. You know, I've got the DDR3 RAM. It's low voltage. It's 4 gigs. I could use this board as is with the 2 HDMI ports, but I really don't want to because I want to be able to use a VGA type adapter or DVI adapter, what have you. So I get on our nice website, eBay. This board alone, this board was going to cost $135. That's right, 135.00 is what this board was going to cost. So I'm like, no, not unless I really, really have to, no. So I started looking at all the other options I could. Started looking at third-party boards, ASUS, ASRock, MSI, you name it, I was looking at motherboards that were socket 1151 that were DDR3. So as I'm going through, I'm noticing a pattern here. The DDR3 boards are not cheap, period. They're just not. They're expensive. So I'm like, all right, I've got an option here. I buy a board directly for the case again and hook everything up as it should be, and we go that way. Or I get an aftermarket board, pray it works with the case, and go from there. Okay. Well, we went with an ASUS H100 or H110MK. This is a refurb from eBay. Works wonderful, as you can tell here. And I think the only thing we're missing from this right now, from the entire system, is an operating system. But just to show. Now, I had to pull RAM from the Ryzen because that's the only DDR4 RAM I have. And unfortunately, DDR4 RAM is not cheap right now. So, let's see what we've got here. Let's just go ahead and zoom in on our screen there. Now, you should be able to see that the BIOS version is 3016. That's all right. You know, I think that's actually out of date. That's perfectly fine. Intel Core i7-6700 CPU at 3.4 gigahertz. Speed is 3,400 megahertz. 8 gigs of RAM, 2133. Now, believe it or not, that stick of RAM is actually 2400. You can see over here we've got a Western Digital 320 gig in it, and a HP HDLS DVD-RW drive. Now, I've got the original chassis fan in there, and the original CPU fan in here as well. You know, right now the motherboard's sitting at 22, as you can tell. The CPU's at 27. Now, just to prove to you guys that this is the RAM from the Ryzen, let's go under our AI tweaker. Alright. Now there's a couple other things I want to change in here real quick. And one of them is here. See, I always like going into advanced mode. What can I say? Save changes, reset, now the reason we're not hearing beeps, postcodes, anything like that, is because I don't have an internal speaker hooked up. So, since this is the first time, you know, I've done that change with the RAM, let's see what happens. I mean, worst thing that can happen is it doesn't boot, okay? I mean, that's the worst thing that's gonna happen. That's easy to fix. Pop open the case and, you know, do it. So, doesn't look like it's gonna boot. It just may not like running a 2400. I don't know. I really haven't messed with an Intel system like this for many, many years. So, that being said, we're going to take our box, throw it down there. We're going to give you guys an inside view. Now, as you can tell, this is not a standard setup for a case. Give you guys an idea. There, right there, is the DVD-ROM burner. And to prove to you that I'm not lying, there you go, Michigan Ridgeback. Focus. Michigan Ridgeback 2400. Yeah, it is. Because it says PC4, focus again, come on. It says PC 2400 on it. So yes, this is the RAM out of the Ryzen. Well, at least one stick. So, let's get this put back in and see what we've got. Oh, I almost put that in the wrong way. Right, now, let's see if it actually gets this time with this. If it doesn't, I'm gonna pop the CMOS off real quick and just clear the flat. Oh, there it goes. We booted! So it may not have liked something I did there, you know. It's complaining because it didn't like running at 2400 megahertz. We've got a bit of LED action in here, right around there. Running this off of the stock original, we'll say the max is like 260 watts continuous, 300 watts max. So there is that. Now, I could have put another power supply in here, however, because this is a slim drive, it's got, you know, the power connector actually for it built into the power supply. On top here we have two USB 3, two USB 2.0, and a card reader port. Now, unfortunately, because of this board, it doesn't have enough USB 2 ports for front panel. It's only got one. So you can hook up two USB 2.0s, that's it. Unfortunately, that's a downside to keeping it in this case. I really don't want to. I most likely won't. But if we had a slightly bigger board, I mean, just to give you an idea as to how big that board is, I'm gonna bring you guys in close on it. So here we go. Okay. Now, make sure I get the, there we go.
Alright.
Right here, kind of blocking it even. Right here, where my finger is, that is one of the standoff mount points for the original motherboard. So, to give you an idea, you know, this board went in this way. I mean, there's that board essentially in the case. Right there. There's the newer board in the case. So, I mean, that board is definitely a lot smaller than this one. So, that's always a good thing. But I'm telling you guys, I did not expect to get this. It is one of the deals that I never thought I'd come across like this. Never thought it would happen. You know, I got really, really lucky it getting this for $10. We've only got, at the moment, maybe $100 to $120 in it. So $10 for the system originally, $60 for the RAM, so that's $70, $40 for the new board. I actually got that board at $39.99, we'll call it $40. So $110 total. You know, it's nice to actually have something to play with again. Don't get me wrong, I love the Ryzen, I love playing on it, it's just I've not had an Intel system this new to play with, so we get to have fun now, I think, because I've got a fourth generation already. I had the Ryzen, and now I've got a sixth generation CPU. So, again, it's a quad-core hyper-threaded CPU, so it's got 4 cores, 8 threads. It's not a Ryzen. I mean, I love my 8 cores, 16 threads here, over here behind me. I love it. I love it. This I got to probably either we might sell it at some point, you know, when we're done really doing testing and everything with it. I don't know. I really haven't made up my mind yet. You know, what do you all want to see happen with this? I mean, do you want us to change out the power supply, get some actual DDR4 RAM maybe? Maybe put a really good video card in it and see how it does gaming? I mean, that's an idea that I'd have right off the bat. So, I mean, we've got that idea, but what do you, the viewers, want to see? With a $10 CPU that's valued at almost $100 to $200, I can ramble all day about it. I'm really happy with it. The reason I've kind of want to keep it in this case, because this case is nice, it's a bit sleek. you know, it's got a very good slim drive in it. Below that drive is actually the 320 gig hard drive, mechanical. We could even pop a solid state in it. You know, it's got the front USB hookups, stuff like that. The only thing that's a downside is I did not get an I.O. shield for the motherboard. So I might actually bend over and actually get one now for like 10 bucks off eBay. What can we do to beat it?
Nothing, right?
But, you know, I'm kind of interested to see what kind of games we could get away with playing. Maybe with medium graphics. I mean, we're not going to do anything high-end graphics with it. But maybe we can figure something out
that's been done.
And I can also, guys, I can tell you right now, the build date of the BIOS is 12/27/16. I know there's a new one. I know one was released right about the beginning of the year. So we'll get that done and dealt with, and leave your comments below. Like the video if you like it. Hate it if you hate it. You know, I kind of like it. I mean, you can hate it for the fact that I paid $10 for that CPU. Yeah, I mean, you can hate it for that. I mean, but like the video at the same time. You know, this is one of our first videos back though, guys. So, really would love to see those likes, the views coming in, and everything else.